Muammar Gaddafi issued an audio statement on Thursday urging residents loyal to him to defeat rebels. In a brief phone call made to Syrian television channel Arai, he also denounced external forces, which he said were spies from Italy and France, who were taking part in the NATO mission responsible for air raid attacks on his troops. He also commented on his alleged flight to Niger.
They say Gaddafi has gone to Niger. How many times have convoys gone backwards and forwards across to Niger? Smugglers and people also crossing into Sudan, Chad, Mali, and Algeria. It is not the first time that people come and go. It's as if this is the first time that a convoy has gone to Niger.
The National Transitional Council has responded to the convoy reports by sending their envoys to Niger in an attempt to detain the fugitive. In light of recent speculation about Gaddafi's whereabouts, Isaka K. Soare, an expert on African conflict prevention studies who is based in South Africa, said it was highly unlikely that the deposed leader would seek refuge outside his country's borders.
It would be quite hazardous and risky for him because these are two poor countries. So if he were to go to any of these countries, Western countries that have been supporting the TNC can certainly put pressure on that country to extradite him. Burkina Faso, I think that is very unlikely. I don't think neither Chad nor Algeria can withstand such a pressure unless he goes there into hiding, whereby he would be safe there, some strict conditions that he cannot engage in any political activities. But other than that, he could go there if he doesn't have any option. But he might as well remain in Libya.
The African Union has recently been active in lobbying for a truce between Gaddafi and opposition leaders in Libya. While Gaddafi has accepted the Union's plan, the NTC has yet to respond. Meanwhile, China said on Tuesday it would join the 60 countries already in acknowledging the NTC as the legitimate governing body in Libya. Noura Faraj, Al Arabiya.